I'm struggling taking pictures. Yeah, remind him, try not to, I know we have to have a chat, but when you go side by side then there becomes pinch points. I'm just worried about people getting clips.
Yeah.
Not good around that bit at all. Not, it's not a good cycling environment at all.
No, I just go through the, well,
the so, I mean, my approach to taking that is always to take the lane and just to be right in the middle of the
So I have to be careful what I start point. I can't go change all this. I'd have to have a chat with our signals team to see what was agreed. Some of it might mean, I would say, blacking out everything, because then driver behaviour changes. Except when it's at night, when you've got a massive wide lane and they're really foot down.
Yeah.
But there's no iterations of it's 20 mile an hour.
That's true, it's only this way, isn't it?
So what we could suggest is to pull a bit of additional 20 mile an hour. It doesn't feel nice going through that. Anybody cycle, plus I would have probably said, then again, how many cyclists cut this way? Would they just go over the bridge to cut back on?
No, I've seen very few people doing that.
Yeah. But you do see cyclists come this way, though.
Yeah.
There is some on the other side, though, through that,
like... There is a cut through around the back there, so you can turn left as you come around.
Yeah.
And it brings you out where Jason's was.
Yeah.
But again, I don't see many people using that.
Yes, I do use that.
They probably don't know it.
No, it's not well sighted, but you can do that if you get the Manby Lane, which is close to
But then also all the chicanes there, even before, where you might, it's, you could sight it, that okay, if you knew the road, you could do a left. With all this construction work and the stuff on this side, you wouldn't see it, that you could turn, you have to do like a sharp turn. You might be thinking of those.
If
you do that, you're going to get hit from behind.
I mean, in a way, it's slightly better at Angel Lane, because you're not going to, it's less likelihood of a left hook.
My approach to it is
to take the lane.
Because
you also have to have good speed. And going through all that.
Guys, we'll go back on the side. Little things like when you have lorries parked out now, if anybody's standing at the crossing to wait, a vehicle wouldn't be able to see them.
Yeah.
And if anybody is vision impaired or disabled or got any learning difficulties, they might step out and drive themselves along. That's why we always say try and get signs and vehicles not to park
around. For that lorry.
If you can zoom in, yours will be a lot better than mine. But also the RMS lorry, you have to be careful when we're going past. Now these guys are trained on not to go that way, but I got out of the bus once and didn't drive with it and changed it because a couple of the bus got taken out half the road three people before. This was it's bad. This was a few years ago and just ripped off the top of the bus. So I think there's mechanisms in now so it doesn't sweep out. But I'm still always very careful when I go past. And also there's a lorry, there could be a door opening. Is the driver in there and that there's two men doing that? But normally it's just one man. But RMS are coming out on a cycle. In fact, if you guys are interested, I didn't think I'd have
I'm not convinced he's on the phone.
I said, you're on my foot. Well, why are you there? Well, why are you on your phone when you're driving?
Nobody will accept that looking at your phone whilst you're driving is wrong.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I call people out on it sometimes and they're so, why aren't you wearing a helmet? How is that even in
sense? Yeah, they try to use that as a kind of
it's your fault, but I think
that's
just some people's reaction.
So what we're going to do, this is kind of like the last stretch. Just have a look, see what that lorry is doing, because I'm going to be feeling that line. Right, I've started this thing called the Cycle Experience. You might have seen it on Twitter. It's called the cycle experience, where I take out directors and CEOs of companies on a segregated bike ride. Just nice, easy ones to Westminster and back. Stop at a few sites where we've done some work to make sure we maintain safety.
Yeah.
Or relationship construction.
Yeah.
And then they come back to the office and we present to them on keeping it safe. But they all say, this is really nice. I've looked at the facility constructors today. I've got testimonials.
Okay.
It's called the Constructor Cycle Experience.
Okay.
And you want to see what these guys are saying. I'll send you the updated one. I've got another six.
So you're going to do it for RMS?
RMS and Knight Harwood and McGee's and Emily's coming up. And,
okay.
Yeah, but I've been going through them now. I've got quite a few.
Oh, well done.
It's a night, you'd enjoy it because you get to have a chat with them, put your point across. But not to pitch them too much because now there's a gentle thing in there. But these are the decision makers.
Yeah.
But I also bring along Oasis, not the group. They're a youth support team. There is a serious side to Oasis though, but what they do is they get called by the hospitals in Southern Finland if one's going to stab in, shoot in of the youth. You know, because the gang
crime. Okay.
They do psychological assessments and try and draw them away from crime into training. So I've been linking them with the construction industry. And
some of them
might
even get
jobs. Yeah, they've got a CSR
training, apprenticeships.
They can apprenticeships, support and training. There's another lady who works for carers. So it's, I'm going down to their setup. What she does is, people who have to look after family day in, day out and don't get support, they send them volunteers for a day. That person comes to the centre, has a massage, is day out. So she's just like, she hasn't been on the bike yet. You can only use pedal me. I'll show you a picture.
Oh,
yeah, well, I'm trying to look after Ben so he gets sorted out as well.
Ben knows.
Yeah,
he's brilliant, isn't he?
But this is the last one. If you talk to Ben, you can mention me so he comes out of the file. He's helped with the design of the traffic management.
Oh, has he?
So he designed that for his bike to get through.
Okay.
So if his bike can get through, these can get through.
Yeah.
I'll show you the last tweet I did on. Yeah, it just gives you a quick idea of the people. The last one was PhD that came out. I did put some on social media, I think it's up to the just smaller size. Right, this is Ben. That's the MD for PhD, because it was raining.
And
this,
oh, lovely.
And this was the group, outside cholesterol. That's Tom at the back. He's the guy from Oasis Youth Group. And this is where we're outside Big Ben. But no, they loved it. Three of the people in there never cycled in London.
Wow. That was their first ever time cycling. Most people wouldn't.
I think there's this concept that it's really unsafe.
Yeah.
When you go on the cycle tracks, they go, this is nice.
Yeah.
I say, what's loads of these?
You feel like cycling in front of a banner, don't you?
Right, so, last bit then. Last 30 still now, isn't it? Chuck round, and this time we'll get back on the safe segregated bit because we are going to do a left and we'll go to Paul's office, stop there, grab a coffee and light up, you know?
West Ham Lane, where that pub is. I'm just on the other side behind the old town hall.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Llewellyn, we're going to turn right into sign.
Hardly.